when I met one anthropologist from Switzerland, his name is Dr. Ulfram Sayer, and I stayed in Weissenhaus in Basel, in the Porfan House, for 6 months, and then I met Dr. Cheryl Harding, the director of Art Basel, and then after that I go to the IAAB, International Outsource Atelier Basel, organized by Christoph Milian Stiftung. So, before I go to Europe, my mother cried because in Java, after the colonization, people believe that if you go from one island to the other island, that means you only have soul, your body is gone. And everyone become, in one island and they didn't cross to the other island. And what I said to my mother, I go to one place only in different area of the earth, only in the corner, another corner of the earth. That means still in the on the earth. And then she feel happy about that. So when I was a student, so in 1984, I used another perception about painting department, that painting as a tools of language. So if I make drawing to other people, maybe they understand this is fish or house or anything like that. So in the sense, I talked to my teacher at the time that painting is over after 4 years studying, because my teacher talked about the composition and many basic technique, and art is not about that. So in 1984, I made a collaboration or sharing with other departments in arts, like in dance or in music, architecture, theater, and other things. So in 1992, we made a cross-cultural discipline that my friend, like from music, he made a painting exhibition, and some painter, they made theater, and some people from theater, they made music. So in 1990, my friend and I, we make a chaotic of the audience about their background, because before we use like tools, like if you use photography, that means oh, you are a photographer, but this is a tool. Everyone can use photography as their their expression. So in sculpture, everyone also can use a yarn, or they can use matchbook or many materials we can use. So in 1992, we made the opposition of Art Biennale in Yogyakarta. But we, at the time the rules is very unfair for young artists. And like the artists cannot participate if they are under 35 years old. So at the time we make Binal. Binal in Indonesian mean wild or out of control, according of the official Binal. So we invite some artists from music department, from dance department, from the traditional artists, about 300, more than 300 artists participate. They exhibit in the railway station, in the hospital, in the boulevard, in the lake, on the road, everywhere. And we invite the people who work with pantomime, many things, like some musicians, they play music with something to use, how to say that, not flute, but to something, yeah, to, yeah, yes, or the saxophone and other things like that. and they make the music score on the wall, very long wall, and this is from the visual art. So we invite people from different disciplines to participate in visual art. So this is maybe my this is the last work, the three dinosaurs actually moving. The moving, all everything moving, like the shadows from the drum, and also of course, on the top of the head, and I make a casting from my body, but I put the head is just as a dinosaurus because my genetic. And this is a proclamacy that about questioning about proclamation is happened in 1945, 17th of August of the independence. But in Indonesia, we still questioning. We still colonized by our people. We call brown colonialism. That means Indonesia colonized by the people themselves. And this work now is in the Tropen Museum, a collection of Tropen Museum. And this one is a ceremony of the soul. This is like 200 kilogram stones from volcano. But on the top is different work. They call the title is Shock Therapy for Political Leaders. They are in my studio. And this is the title is Pseudo-Development Ancestors. So every figure is about 3 meters. And about the leaders whom they promised to us. And we become victim from them. And this is Puppet, Washington Puppet. I participated in anti-documenta in, I think, in 2000. Yeah, maybe 2000, the year 2000. In Documenta 10 at the Police Academy. And this one is Raden Saleh with 1,000 power of the horsepower. And actually Raden Saleh became a cosmopolitan artist in early 19th centuries in Europe. And he's very close friend with Hans Christian Andersen and also with Robert Schumann, the composer. And he based in Dresden. He has the blue house in Maxen, the small, very small village that he made a blue house. So a few years ago, I made solo exhibition in Schloss Maxen. This one in the National Gallery Jakarta about Raden Saleh. Maybe. You don't know Raden Saleh, but he's the first Indonesian modern artist in our history. I've lived in Europe for 20 years. This is watching the stupidity when, I think 3 years ago, some curators in Indonesia said that I already, because I'm 53 years old, so they said I already retired as an artist. So now they said not necessarily anymore, I create artwork. And my price in the auction house is not so hot, he said. And he said every institution wrong, galleries, museum, curators, everybody, only him right. So he said Harry Bono is the wrong artist. But I said yes, I'm the wrong artist, but I go to in the right way. But he's the right curator, but he go to the wrong way. So after that, I make a comment through this work called Watching the Stupidity. And this is moving neck, moving like that. And this is watching the marginal people. So because everywhere already, I think, this is in 1992. I believe everywhere in the world already marginalized. There is no center anymore. So network sculpture is a good point, I think, when we have to make network. because to centralize everything is nonsense. Everything important. Everybody, every artist, every human being are important. So this word, watching, you know, they move the eyes to see the audience, because actually my belief is fine art. We call also animism, that we believe everything has soul. So the artwork itself, watching the audience everywhere they exhibit, and they have transistor radio, and transistor radio can transform the radio, the news from everywhere in the world.
Does it also have sound?
Really? They have sound, yeah. This is from different angle. This unstained. This is a part of the close up of the 10 pieces of astronaut. The title is unidentified and flying object. That's also moving, and we are in my studio. This one, another work, they call the troops of extraterrestrial. So this is an exhibit in the Artscape Singapore, in Marina Bay Sands. They have a container for craters, actually, the container for crater, the land. And this is angels falling from the sky. That before I make this work, I make for Sao Paulo Biennale, the title is Angels Catch on the Trap. So angels, there is no connection with any religions, but angels for me is a symbol of inspiration, because our inspiration never go back, we always go forward. So, but because in 1996 we still in military country is still in military state, like dictatorship. So our inspiration always cannot go through, because they put in propaganda and everything like that. So many of the exhibitions sometimes put in the cross line from the police before the opening. And sometimes you have to make 11 stand for police or from different institutions, 11 institutions to get permission. And before the opening, sometimes they have like a spy to check you make political issue or not. So before,
censorship.
Yeah, many artists, you know, we have a problem. Some, like in our history, like Hendra Gunawan, he already passed away, but he put in the jail for 13 years. You know, like, and some artists also disappear. And but now maybe after 1998, we are in the civil government. So also I make exhibition in London, and not in Oxford, in MoMA Oxford. The Indonesian embassy in London asked to the Museum of Modern Art to withdraw the catalog. And I exhibit, the title is Blooming in Arms, you know, like with seven figures, with chicken wire and camouflage. And I paint all the wall and the floor in khaki color. And, you know, like, but also I had problem at the time to say sorry to the Indonesian government, you know, with some pages of letters. And, yeah, at the time it's a difficult situation, because when I arrived at the airport, so the police already wait, you know, and put 2 days in the police headquarters of many questions. So today I come to my parents' house and said to my mother my flight delay in Singapore. So that the angels, I said to the Indonesian government, is not as political message. This is mean the angels falling from the sky is as a discourse, not as discourse anymore. They have to go down to go to the earth. So these angels as a, like a series, but I don't have when I picture when I exhibit in Sao Paulo in 1997. This is political clown with underneath they have some bottle with urine, like with urine. We call it a urinal energy. And the political clown mean that actually people not so stupid about to know about the country, but they get suppressed by military system. This is a casting from my face. Actually, I just at the time make experiment about to cast my face every 10 years because it's more authentic to make this casting. But at that time my friend didn't know how to help me to make a, you know, like a casting put with the gypsum. So the pipe is so long, you know, very long. And then he put Vaseline on my face and then put gypsum, yeah, very, very thick and very hot, you know, like after 15 minutes. And then I cannot shout because only the pen is under, like very hot, something like that. And then he put also until my ear, so I can use a hammer to almost died, I think. And then, and then he made another times, you know, and I put newspaper in my eyes because I'm afraid if the Vaseline comes to my eyes. And then finally we can make this face, yeah. And then he, yeah, but he said, oh, you're not a sculptor, maybe you want to go to other, you know, like to take over our area in sculpture. When I made it, it's different, not as a sculpture like he told. Because this is like a language for get the phenomenon. So in our concept of create sculpture, actually we don't talk about the composition, preface and other thing. We base on the mandala perspective. So in mandala perspective, we don't have concept of object. Because we believe every element has soul, from air, water, clay, you know, everything in our life, we connect it from, we become, we as microcosmos, and in the end we go to macrocosmos. That's why if you go to Bali, you can see people make staircase to go to one area to the other. Because before you go to one area, you remember you will see the sky. And then after that, you go to the garden or other space. So everybody can get remind about their life from microcosmos from microcosmos to macrocosmos. So in mandala system, like in Borobudur temple, we have the Buddhist temple. Everyone in the temple, there is no distance between subject and object, because the Borobudur is subject, not object. And I make also the project called Trojan Horse, and everyone can go to inside the sculpture. I make 8 meters with the cardboard, and then I make periscope inside the Trojan Horse. So from inside they can see their friend. So their friend is not object, their friend is still subject. So because we sometimes think about we are the center of universe, but actually we are a part as a network of everything. So installation or sculpture are based on this mandala. This is flying in the cocoon. This is in 1998. I criticized about the reform, because the reform actually sometimes like only word, not connection with change the mindset of people about to go to the civil government. And like cocoon, actually they become warm and then become a butterfly. But this angel is like butterfly, but inside, they never go outside. Just look at what happened outside. This is I exhibit also in the Tropen Museum in 2009 for the exhibition so-called the Donor Code. Instead of the Da Vinci Code, I try to make the code of myself. This is in National Gallery after, I think in 2004, I make more flying angels. So angel is flying just everywhere. And also my painting, I make painting. Painting is my foundation for my source of get income. Because I like to manage myself to get income for my project, so I not depend on any institution. So if I sell my painting, I can create many artwork. And in this is only the female in the front, only one, and the other is male angels. This is fermentation of mind. The works, when I remember from primary school until high school, I always get punishment from my teacher. You cannot say no, you only can say yes. So, but this work is also to create myself, to make healing, like healing system about get a lot of propaganda. So why I have to say yes all the time, and this is nodding head like that. And they give a lot of propaganda in your mind, and then difficult to disappear all things. And they have all sound and many things like that. And the chair, actually, one of the school, the sports school, they call SGO is Sekolah Guru Olahraga. That means the sports school for teacher. And they want to destroy all of the desk, because in Indonesian system, you cannot give to other school. The only thing you have to destroy, and they ask to Jakarta to get new chair, a new desk. So when before they destroy it, I choose 15 pieces, and I buy to them and put in my studio. And they have a chanting like loop cassettes about propaganda from Indonesia. And this is Born in Freedom. This is based on the song Born Free. And then in Indonesia they said, now you freedom, you can say anything you like, but they still put the chain. You cannot go anywhere like that. So they treat us like more like animals rather than human. Oh, finish.